it's 6 o'clock in the morning, Friday. We're off to the Blackpool Storybrooke Free Convention, and we're going to head in to get the train from here, train to Glasgow, and then from Glasgow to Preston. And we're going to take it from there. This is the first vlog that I've ever done, so we're just basically going to take you around everything that's going to happen this full weekend. From the check-in for Rogue Events Storybrooke Free. All I can say is that was an absolute nightmare. We went in there at 3 o'clock. We queued up till 7 o'clock at night, going through all the different things you need to get in, register, get your ticket for the event and your pass. Then you had to go around the other side of the hotel to get your autographs. So, no signs for queues, so everybody was just queuing up anywhere. Nobody knew what queue was what. People were just joining everything. It was a mess. We eventually got in one queue and they said, "Oh, are you buying autographs or are you picking up autographs or is it a raffle?" He says, "Oh, it was tickets that was prepaid for, so you went to this queue over here." So we were in there for 2.5 hours, got to the end of the queue, got our stuff, and then handed over another receipt and they says, "Oh, you need to wait in that other big queue because that never went through." So we were in that queue for another about 40 minutes or something like that. Anyway, it was a bit of a mess. All they had to do was put signs up and people would queue at them, and so much easier, but hopefully tomorrow goes a bit better. So in your wee book we got, this is what you pay your money for, all these wee tickets, which they could have posted out, would have been a lot easier. Free with your pass. These tickets are for free autographs for standard guests, and a wee booklet which has like a map of the place, hold on, and like a schedule for all the people, what days they're doing autographs, photographs and talks, and the plan of a hotel, and basically just a wee book about all the different characters. So I'm going to bed because I'm fucking knackered. Been up since 5 o'clock this morning getting ready, so
baby, I make your legs shake, you make me go crazy. Come, my lady, come. come, come, my lady. You're my butterfly, sugar, baby. Come, my lady, you're my pretty baby. I make your legs shake, you make me go crazy. Come, my lady, come, come, my lady. You're my butterfly, sugar, baby. Come, my lady, you're my pretty baby. I make your legs shake, you make me go crazy. Come, my lady, come, come, my lady. You're my butterfly, sugar, baby. Come, my lady, you're my pretty baby. I make your legs shake, you make me go crazy. Such a sexy, sexy, pretty little thing. Your information got me sprung with your tongue ring. And I ain't gonna lie, cause your loving keeps me high. So to keep you by my side, there's nothing that I won't try. Butterflies in the eyes and the looks to kill. Time is passing, I'm asking, could this be real? Cause I can't sleep, I can't hold still. The only thing I really know is she got sex appeal. And I can feel too much is never enough. You always gotta keep me up when these times get rough. I was like,
are you wrong about
it? Didn't you? This guy's an amazing artist, by the way. Amazing artist.
Thanks very much.
The question is, if Rumble and Big Bay had a fight, who do you think would win, and what would you think if Big Bay stabbed him and be the new Big Bay Dampon? I quite like that, actually. It's a scary one. I can write that. Well, I think obviously it would be, it's no contest, you know what I mean, because obviously Rumble's not going to have magic, so it's going to let us over, it's over. In the blink of an eye, he'd probably turn it into a snail and step up. So Big would have much. He would have to get that dagger very, very quickly. Of course, if he did get that dagger, he'd probably plunge it. And that would be a very scary proposition.
You've been in college. Thanks.
No worries.
So I'm just back from Blackpool. We were down there for Storybook Free. It ended up quite good actually. The Sunday was a lot better than the Saturday, and we got everything signed. You know, the people who run it get a lot of harsh criticism, but you know, that many people work at that many people working there, like at the one time trying to sort everything out. And you know, there was a guy called Brian who was there, who was just brilliant. As far as staff go, he was probably the best one. And Andy, he was really good. We had a couple of pints with him after it. He was really nice. And Wayne was alright as well. So, you know, these things are so hard to plan, and with so many guests trying to keep everything running and getting everything signed and pictures and all that. I was a bit harsh at the start of the video because, like, on Saturday I'd done absolutely nothing, all I'd done was talk, so, like, I have to squeeze everything into one day, and it's stressful for people to do that, and, you know, it's one of these things people are going to complain about it because people don't like being stressed, and I think if they can do away with this alphabetical numbers, the letters they give out to people, that it just doesn't work, like for autographs and stuff like that, because they're calling different letters at different times for different people. So you get your free autographs, and you can, they run through, so you can go in and get your free autographs, and then say you're like R, and you're in there getting your free autographs, but there's like a higher bracket guest who's signing, but they've not called your number yet. You can just join their queue because you're already in there, and there's people outside who are in a category before you, but because you're already in there, you join your queue, you get your stuff signed. So right there is why the alphabetical stuff doesn't work. But, you know, they did try the hardest to get everybody who didn't have their stuff signed, get it all done on Sunday. Emily De Raven was signing from 2:30. She was meant to finish at 4:00. She stayed an extra hour and a half. The queue kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, and eventually they have to stop it and go, look, she can't sign anymore. And they done that, and there was a few unhappy people, but she can't sit there all night signing stuff. So, but overall it was good. We got to meet Robert, got the painting signed. I met everybody else, got all my autographs for all the free autographs. We also got Lana as well, and got to ask a question in the Q&A with Robert, which was amazing. I've never stood up in front of a whole room of people to ask a question before. I was a bit nervous, but you know, hopefully that'll give me confidence to do it again. And we just after that, just traveling home, was a bit of a slog after 3 days of heavy queuing and everything, but I don't think it was as bad as I thought it was going to be. I heard a lot of bad reviews about Rogue, and some of it you can understand, and other parts of it, I mean, some of the stupid questions is just unreal, but you're going to get that anywhere. So I think I will probably do another one again, but I think they do need to change the whole layout of the alphabetical stuff, because it's just so confusing for people. And if you don't have Twitter, you're running about looking like asking people, and they're like, no, you can't wait here, it's not your group time and stuff like that. So it needs to be simpler. But it was good on Sunday, getting all the stuff done and getting all your autographs and pictures. And the talks were really good, especially Sean. Sean was really good, and Robert was really good. Lana's was alright, but you've got loads of Lana fans who go to these things and they sit and they talk in their group rather than listening to what she's got to say, and it's really quite annoying. I mean, you go to watch her talking, and all you can hear is these people talking amongst themselves and laughing, and it is really annoying. I mean, I don't know why you would go there to see someone talking, but then talk over the top of her. It's and so many questions as well. I just don't know where people think of them, but you know, it's up to them if they want to ask a question like that. And fair enough. But hopefully you like the vlog. We're going to put some pictures on as well, and also, I get an email when I come back. Somebody had took a wee sneaky video of me asking a question in the Robert Carlyle Q&A, so hopefully I'm going to put that in as well. And hopefully you like the vlog, subscribe, share, and well, who knows, there might be a second one.
Come a lady, yeah. 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 Come a lady, ye